Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 1.2, Problem 8. This is problem number 8 from Section 1.2 of the homework. It says, when the Patriots make it to the postseason, the supply equation for Patriots hooded sweatshirt is P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.4 Q plus 19. And the demand equation is P equals D parentheses Q equals negative 0.5 Q plus 100. And then based on that information, there are five separate parts, A through E, that we can answer. And the first of those five, part A, says, at a price of $43, what quantity of sweatshirts will be supplied? So, in other words, if they can sell for $43, how many of them will the sweatshirt company be willing to make? So because it asks about supply, I'm going to choose the supply equation from the question, which is P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.4 Q plus 19. Now, the S parentheses Q just identifies this as being the supply equation as opposed to the demand. Once I know I've chosen the correct equation, I don't really need to write that part. I'll just write P equals 0.4 Q plus 19. Now, the $43 in the question is a price. So I put in 43 for P because P is for price, and I solve for Q for quantity. So 43 equals 0.4 Q plus 19. Now, get the Q by itself. So I'm going to subtract 19 on both sides of the equation, on the left side and the right side. So now, positive 43 negative 19 will give me a result of positive 24. And on the right side, I have 0.4 Q. The positive 19, negative 19 cancel. So now to solve for Q, divide out the 0.4. So I'm going to have 24 divided by 0.4 equals 0.4 Q divided by 0.4. I'm dividing both sides by 0.4, the value in front of the Q. On the left side, I can see that the answer is 60. If you don't, just use your calculator. 24 divided by 0.4. However you do it, you'll get that the answer is 60. And on the right side, 0.4 Q over 0.4. The 0.4s cancel, of course. And you have 60 equals Q. The quantity is 60. So at a price of $43 each, the company that makes the sweatshirts will be willing to make a quantity of 60 sweatshirts. So part B of the question says, if a quantity of 43 sweatshirts are supplied, what is the price? So again, because the question asks about supply, we start with the supply equation, which is P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.4 Q plus 19. And once I get started with this, I don't need the S parentheses Q. Again, this is just to identify this equation as being the supply equation as opposed to the demand equation. So I'm just going to write P equals 0.4 Q plus 19. Now, the 43 is going to go in for Q because the 43 is a quantity, and then I'll solve for P. So P equals 0.4 times 43 plus 19. So P equals 0.4 times 43 multiplies out to 17.2, and we'll add 19 to that. And when you add 17.2 plus 19, we're going to get P equals 36.2. Now, because this is a P, it's P for price, that 36.2 is really $36.20. So, if the company makes 43 sweatshirts, that must have meant that they're able to sell them for $36.20 each. That's what the answer means that you found. Now, part C, it says, at a price of $43, what quantity of sweatshirts will be demanded? So now we're talking about demand. So we're going to go to the demand equation, which is P equals D parentheses Q equals negative 0.5 Q plus 100. So now the 43 that's given is a price that'll go in for P. And as usual, I don't need to write the D parentheses Q. That's written initially in the given information, so you can easily distinguish which equation is supply and which is demand. The D is for demand, it's that simple. So as we put in the 43, we can really put it into this equation, P equals negative 0.5 Q plus 100. And again, don't lose that negative 0.5. That makes a big difference. So the P is $43, so it becomes 43 equals negative 0.5 Q plus 100. So now to solve for Q, first get the 100 out of the right side. So I'm going to do minus 100 on the right, minus 100 on the left. On the left, positive 43 and negative 100 is negative 57. Again, pay attention to the signs. And negative 57 equals negative 0.5 Q. And on the right, the positive 100, negative 100 have canceled, those are gone. So now to solve for Q, I want to divide out the negative 0.5 that's in front. So on the left side, I'm going to have negative 57 divided by negative 0.5. equals negative 0.5 Q divided by negative 0.5. So on this side, the negatives will cancel, and this divides out to 114. Again, you might not see that without your calculator. So you can do negative 57 divide by negative 0.5 equals, and the calculator will tell you quick enough that it's 114. And on the right, negative 0.5 Q over negative 0.5, the negative 0.5s cancel, so the quantity is 114. So, if people are willing to pay $43 per sweatshirt, 114 of them will be purchased by shoppers. Part D says, if a quantity of 43 sweatshirts is demanded, what is the price? So again, because this asks for demand, I'm going to start with a demand equation, which is P equals D parentheses Q equals negative 0.5 Q plus 100. That's the demand equation, and I use that one as opposed to supply because the question asks specifically about demand. And again, the D parentheses Q is just to identify this as the demand equation as opposed to the supply. Once I know I have the correct equation, I don't need this extra part. I can write P equals negative 0.5 Q plus 100. And now I can use that. The 43 that's given is a quantity. It says if a quantity of 43 is demanded. So find the price. So the 43 goes in for quantity. So P equals negative 0.5 times Q becomes negative 0.5 times 43, the value of Q, plus 100. So now P equals negative 0.5 times 43 is negative 21.5. And we still have to do plus 100. So negative 21.5 plus 100, P will equal positive 78.5. So now that 78.5 is a P, so P for price. The 78.5 is really $78.50. And finally, the most important part of the question, what is the market price? So for market price, we have to figure out where will supply equal demand. When does that occur? So the supply equation is given. It is P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.4 Q plus 19. When is that equal to the demand, which is P equals D parentheses Q equals negative 0.5 Q plus 100. So that's the supply equaling the demand. Now, the way the equation is written now, there's so many equal signs in it. I'd like it to have just one equal sign. So to start off with, The S parentheses Q in the supply equation does not need to be written, and the D parentheses Q in the demand equation does not need to be written. That's unnecessary. And we can also get rid of the P that's showing up on both sides of the equation. So when you get rid of that, on the left side for supply, we have 0.4Q plus 19 equals, and on the right, we're going to have negative 0.5Q plus 100. We want to see what value of Q is going to make that equation true. That will determine where supply is equal to demand. Now, to solve this for Q, I'd like to have Q only on one side of the equation instead of on both sides. So let me start by adding 0.5Q on both the right side and the left side of this equation. On the left, positive 0.4Q plus another positive 0.5Q is going to make positive 0.9Q plus 19 equals, and on the right I just have 100. So 0.9Q plus 19 equals 100. I'd rather not have the 19 on the left side. So on the left I will subtract 19, which means on the right I must also subtract 19. So when I do that, on the left side of the equation, I'm just going to have 0.9Q. And on the right, positive 100 and negative 19 is 81. So I have 0.9Q equals 81. To solve for Q, divide out the 0.9. So I'm going to have 0.9Q divide by 0.9 equals 81 divide by 0.9. Right? I divide both sides of the equation by the value in front of my unknown variable. So on the left, 0.9Q over 0.9, the 0.9s just cancel for me, giving me Q. That's what I want. 81 divided by 0.9 is 90. Now again, that might not be something that you're comfortable doing in your head. So with your calculator, just do 81 divided by 0.9 equals, and you'll see that it is 90. So Q is 90. Now, that's not the answer yet. That's right so far, but that's not what the question asks us for. This is the market quantity. The question asks, what's the market price? So now that we have the quantity, we can put that quantity of 90 into either the supply equation and find the price, or we can put the quantity of 90 into the demand equation and find the price. We should get the same answer either way. I will choose the supply equation just because it doesn't have a negative in it. It's positive. So again, like I say, you should get the same answer either way. The supply equation is P equals S parentheses Q equals 0.4Q plus 19. So as we've done in the past, I don't need the S parentheses Q. It makes it more complicated than it needs to be. Let me just do P equals 0.4Q plus 19. Now the value of Q I'm going to put in here is 90. So P equals 0.4 times Q becomes 0.4 times 90 plus 19. So now 0.4 times 90 is 36, and I still have plus 19. And if I add 36 and 19, that adds up to 55. And now because it's P that's 55, it's really $55. So the actual market price for these sweatshirts is $55 each. That's what we found here, and a quantity of 90 will be purchased.